this is Daniel Quinones with MLoveism TV, and I'm here with
Chase Tafoya.
We're gonna sit down and chop it up and talk about these awesome pieces of artwork. Let's start with what got you into doing your artwork and kind of getting into this direction.
Okay, I started drawing at the age of 3. I drew my entire life. Then when I was in my senior year of high school, I picked up a paintbrush and I started painting, and I did that for probably a good 10 years. I emailed probably literally over 100 different galleries all over the world, mm-hmm. trying to get my name out as an artist. And I got picked up right away, and I got like a really big art show here in Los Angeles, and with a bunch of really big name artists. And from there, I started doing graphic design work for all sorts of people, famous musicians, bands, clothing companies, you know, private celebrity clientele, that kind of stuff.
Can you kind of dive back up in the story and dive into the what you had to do to do the legwork for you as an artist? Can you break that down, what you had to do?
I would contact different galleries, and I would let galleries know, hey, look, I'm an up-and-coming artist. If you are ever interested in showing, you know, some fresh new talent, just please keep me in mind. I mean a lot. Out of like 100 galleries, I probably got yes by like maybe one or two. So I probably got like 97, 98 no's, you know?
Was your artwork like faith-based, or were you just kind of still figuring out who you were as an artist?
You know what's interesting is originally my artwork out the gate was very, very faith-based. And as I got more and more involved in the art industry and more involved with making money, I started seeing it as like, wow, I can make a lot of money doing this.
Yeah.
You know, and all I have to do is just sacrifice just a little bit of what I'm about.
When did you, kind of realize, man, this is whack. I mean, this isn't fulfilling me, and I have everything what a supposed made artist should have in the industry?
It hit me one day. Mm-hmm. I was like, I'm not doing artwork to praise God. Mm-hmm. I'm not doing artwork to glorify Him, And as an artist, with the gifts that we have, you can either glorify the world or you could, glorify God. I'm wrapping a bunch of design work for people that I've already, locked into, that I already promised I would do. Mm-hmm. And after that, I'm just gonna take some time off, and I'm gonna start focusing back on my portrait painting, and I'm gonna do a bunch of new series, all faith inspired,
Why don't you kind of let the audience know what goes inside your mind and the painting process now with this kind of new outlook on why you are creating artwork?
For instance, this one I'm doing of the beheading of St. John, I was reading Bible scripture, and I came to that, and something just spoke to me, and I was like, I got this quick flash of an image in my mind of how I would do that. Mm-hmm. And so I said, wow, that would be a cool pick, And then from there, I just, I'll search for a subject to do a portrait of, and even that's super important to me now, whereas, prior I would just pick anybody. Now it's almost like, who's the person behind the portrait? What do they represent? What is their walk like? So once I get, a portrait person set up, I'll take a picture of them, I'll start the actual portrait painting, and then I'll just kind of just see what happens.
You're obviously interacting with a lot of people. Can you give us like the most memorable conversation or feedback that you have? And then vice versa, the most like negative thing that you've heard about your work?
For sure, I think some of the most memorable things for me is I get a lot of up and coming artists who contact me and who will tell them like, hey man, I used to do art as a kid, I never picked up the brush in years, and after seeing your work, you got me inspired again to do artwork. As far as the negative stuff, unfortunately I've had a lot of negative stuff. I've had, people asked to take my artwork down in galleries. I've had people threaten to slash my artwork.
Why is that?
I don't know, man. People just trip. A lot of times the imagery, I even had this one woman one time tell me that she took offense. She was a curator of a gallery. She told me that she took offense to a piece that I had done because the person kind of represented Jesus, kind of had a Jesus pose to it. And she said as a pagan, she took offense to that.
Wow.
And it had to come down.
All right, so we asked all our guests here, what they're doing to fill in the blank in terms of, in a world that's kind of so lost, or the I generation where it's all about me, but they still come empty, just like you've experienced. What are you doing as an artist to fill in the blank?
In a world filled with so much negativity and self-indulgence, I'm just trying to be, you know, as positive as possible, and I'm trying to constantly remain humble and be a servant, you know.
Let them know where they can see your work and, you know, any other affiliations that you have.
Sure.
That you want to just kind of tell the audience.
Yeah, you guys can check me out on chasetafoya.com, facebook.com/chasetafoya, and also on the whosoevers.com.
I'm Daniel Quinones with Chase Tafoya. Don't forget to check out the next MLoveism TV. And remember, fill in the blank. Peace.
Peace.